Alrighty guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. So first off, I really want to apologize. I haven't made a video for like 5-6 months. I don't know. It's been busy, you know, school, all that. But now that school's out, it's the summer, and now I just have a lot more time to make this. So today we're going to be starting a new series, actually. It's going to be called, I think I'd want to call it, Getting Started with Mongoose. So for those of you guys who do not know what Mongoose is actually, it's a way for Node.js. It makes it really easy to connect to MongoDB with Node.js. Yes, so it basically creates everything in a really fast, simple, easy manner that allows you to reuse it and create models and a bunch of other cool stuff that we'll get into in a little bit. So first thing I want to do is jump into my terminal, and in my terminal I've already seeded into my desktop directory. Then what I basically want to do is just create a new Express project, and I think I'm going to call it Start Mongoose. So with that, it created all the files that are needed, and then let's just copy this command right here so we can cd into it, and then npm install. So I'm not going to make you guys just watch through all this NPM installing, just because it's going to take a little while. But for the time being, let's just cut the video. So actually what ended up happening is I cut the video, and legitimately right after I cut the video, what ended up happening is it all got installed and everything was installed nice and well. So let's just clear this real quick. And then, just to make sure all of this is working, let's just do npm start so we can check out what is going on with this. So let's navigate over to localhost colon 3000, and there we go. Express. Welcome to Express. So that was just the default thing that Express basically sets up for us. So then, with that, let's keep that tab open. That's probably a good idea. So then, let's jump right into it inside of brackets. And I got it on my desktop, and it's right, yeah, Start Mongoose. Alright, so let's open that right up. So the first thing I want to look at right now is the package.json file. Right here we can see all the dependencies that are currently needed in order to serve this. And so what's really great about a package.json file is that if we list out all our dependencies here, then when we go over to our terminal and run npm install, then what we can do is it will automatically install all the dependencies here. So probably the first dependency that we're actually going to want to install is it's actually Mongoose. So npm install -s save Mongoose. So when we do the save parameter in this, what happens is it will save it into the package.json. So then anyone else who uses this project will be able to use that and check it out as well. So let's just let that build. I'm going to cut the video right again. Hopefully it won't be the same dumb thing. Alrighty guys, so just like that, we can now see that we have Mongoose straight up right there installed. So the first thing that then we're going to want to do is head on over here into the app.js. So for you guys that are kind of new to Node.js and Express.js, basically what the app.js file is, it's the main center for all your code. So you're going to have things that are being imported, such as the routes. You're going to have other sorts of things, like you're going to be importing and requiring all the dependencies that you have over here in your package.json. You're going to set things like the view engine, for example, Jade. You're going to have static files in this directory, which has gotten set up right there. And it just basically adds a lot of functionality right off the bat. And then we also have things such as if there's like a 500 error or if there's a 404 error, all those sorts of cool things that are just great that are built right out of the box. So let's get right into it. So right up here after body parser, let's do var mongoose equals require mongoose. So right then, now you can see what's going on. So I'm gonna actually jump around a little bit, and I'm gonna jump into the layout.jade file. And so actually what I wanna do is go over here to the AngularJS page, and I just wanna copy this CDN. So, and then down here, let's install it. All right, there we go. All right, guys, so let's just jump right back into it. So I'm gonna go back over to Bootstrap, and I'm just gonna go click the Getting Started Guide, and I'm just gonna right here copy all the CSS. Just with Bootstrap, it allows to code up everything that we are gonna be building much faster, so we don't have to worry about styling and many of the other things that are part of normal building that you have to deal with. And let's also just grab that JavaScript in case we do anything with JavaScript. Actually, no, let's not actually, because then we have to require jQuery, and then there's just more and more dependencies that we have to require, and it gets annoying and it's dumb. So let's just delete all this stuff in the body styles right now, and let's head over to the index.jade. So first thing we want to do is just create a form, and then inside this form let's have an input, and then let's just do a placeholder, and inside this placeholder we're going to have name. So, and then at the same time we're also going to have ng-model is post.name. And then right down here at the bottom, let's have a button, and it's going to be button.button-default. And then let's have ng-click equals send, and then it's going to send post. So right then there, we got it. And then let's just add a form control so we can make it look a little bit nicer. So over, I remembered that we actually need to hook it all up. So let's go into our JavaScripts and let's create a file called index.js. And then in this index.js, let's do var app equals require, or sorry, not, what am I doing? Var app equals angular.module. And then inside this, let's just call it app. And for now, we're not going to be passing in any parameters. So we're going to do app.controller, and it's just going to be our main controller, and then we'll just run a function with it. And then let's require some dependencies parameters. And then one of them is going to be scope, obviously. And we'll put scope here too. So let's just do scope dot test equals, let's just keep it as hey, just to keep it simple. And over back here in the layout.jade, we're going to write off, just do ng-app equals app, and then right here we'll do another script, and then the source is going to be JavaScripts / index.js. So then if we can go back to the index.jade, and then we can try to get test working, and if all works, which I'm sure it won't, because, you know, of course nothing ever works right off the bat, but if we can get that all to work, it'll be great. So next thing we're going to want to do is just do nodedaemon/bin/www, just because that's actually the starting file for us. The www for us, it's over here in the bin, and you can see it all in here, and that's actually what starts the server for us, not the app.js in our case. So if you load up the page, of course it's probably not going to work, because, yeah, like I already said, nothing ever really works right off the bat. So right here in the test, we can just double check the console, see what's going on, and just letting you guys know that I actually haven't really made anything beforehand for this. So I've just kind of been going off my head of what I've been thinking that we should have. So of course I remember what we need. We need ng-controller equals main controller. Of course, how could I forget that? Now we can see, hey, awesome. So let's just put all of our block content in a div.container just so it looks a bit more beautiful. All right, awesome. So now that we got that working, that's beginning to look pretty awesome, if I do say so myself. And of course, let's just add send. Cool. So now we can see it looks pretty good, and we got something going on so far. So guys, if you really enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button. I'm definitely going to be continuing the series, and hopefully throughout the summer and maybe more into the school year, I'll be able to make more and more YouTube videos. So anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.